Steve Fleming, and these are my titles.
Plus, or what?
There's Holly Willoughby coming out of a giant clam. Still got them bangers, boy. There's Phil Cotton with a bow and arrow. Careful, that nearly went inside me. And there's Gino De Campo with a tiny willy. We're all in heaven, but don't worry, we're not dead. It's just an over-elaborate metaphor for how great this show is. We're still here to make the best telly show on telly. What is that telly show on telly? Celebrity Juice on telly. HD Red.
Keith Lemon, welcome to Celebrity Juice. This is the only time I get to hang out with the fittest birds on telly. Let's meet them. First up, it's Holly Willoughby! Who's on your team?
What's the situation? I'll tell you what the situation is. Eamon Holmes is here!
Holly! 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 I've got to stop you there!
What?
What's the situation? What's the situation?
Situation. What's the situation? Yeah. I'll tell you what the situation is.
That's it.
And on my left, he's the quiz show host. It's definitely not pointless. It's Richard Osman.
I'm very well, Keith. Are you well?
Yeah, well, I'm good.
You look well.
Yeah, yeah, I feel good about myself. I don't care if I've got ginger hair. I don't care.
That's not ginger, that's sort of autumn sunset.
It's autumn sunset, so fuck you all! OK, let's meet our other team captain, it's Fern Cotton! Fern, who's on your team?
Well, on my left is Gino Sheffield De Campo. Right, it's my old mucker off EastEnders, Denise Van Outen!
She's your old mucker off EastEnders.
She is.
When were you in EastEnders?
She's my old mucker, like, we're old mates.
Yeah.
Now she's in EastEnders. I should have put a comma in there.
Well, you should have said, she's my old mucker who is now on EastEnders, not my old mucker from EastEnders, like,
she
used to be on EastEnders.
Are you actually correcting the way she speaks?
I am, Ollie, yeah.
I thought it sounded like she was on EastEnders as well.
Oh, right, shut
up. Hey,
here we go.
Did you think that?
I thought you had a part of EastEnders.
I'll do it again.
I never make me sick when I'm the captain.
Now, on my right, my old mucker, Comma, who is also in EastEnders. It's Denise Van Outen!
But she also said, who is also in EastEnders, as if she was in EastEnders.
Oh, God!
I honestly don't remember Fern being in EastEnders.
No, I can't remember. You've got Gino on your team this week. Normally, when Gino's on someone's team, they lose.
Ill-fated team. This week.
Yeah. It's been a nightmare, seriously. I've always used to win before, but now it's gone a bad run.
It's the sixth episode. That's something to celebrate, isn't it?
Yeah.
So we're going to have a special twist to the end of the programme, which is all in this envelope. That's exciting, isn't it, Eamon?
Very exciting.
Yeah. Don't shoot yourself. Leave it there, and all will be revealed at the end of the show. Richard Osman, everyone! Do you mind if I call you Rich?
Yeah, go ahead.
Rich.
Do you mind if I call you Key?
You can call me Key, yeah?
Lem, the Lemster.
The Lemster? The Lemster. Rich, you've made nearly 700 episodes of the massively successful quiz show Pointless.
Yeah.
For anyone who hasn't seen Pointless, what's the message?
Well, the message is simply it's a quiz show where you have to pick an answer that the fewest people can remember. So you've got to find the most obscure answer possible. Yeah. It's the opposite of Family Fortunes.
That's the peripherals of the show. Yeah. What's the message of the show?
Oh, the message is stay off drugs.
Yeah.
Stay in school.
It's not a pointless message, is it?
Oh, I see what you did.
You come across like a nice, straight enough guy. But you do have a bad side, don't you?
Oh, I've got terrible.
Is it true that you once got Bradley Walsh in a headlock and punched him in the cock because you hate the chase so much?
No, I got him in a cock block and punched him in the head.
Hey, it's Denise Van Outen!
Yeah!
Are you well?
I'm good, thanks.
Long time no see.
I know, it's been a while.
It has, hasn't it?
I haven't stopped thinking about you since.
I haven't either. I was just saying to Gino earlier, if I had a pound for every time I've pumped fist to you, I'd have 753 quid. And now you're in EastEnders.
Yep, that's right.
Crazy times. You called Karen Smart.
Karen Smart.
Karen.
Yeah.
Not Karen. When you're doing snogging, are you sort of kind of act that goes full tongue?
I'll go for it, yeah.
Put the finger in the ass, feel the
all
balls.
All of it, yeah.
No, what do you do with your tongue? Does it go back like a parrot? Or do you really get involved?
Well, you can do. Some actors like to.
Well, if it were Malcolm Smith.
Actually, I have done, so I did a film with him.
Oh, you did a film with him?
Yeah, of course. I have done, yeah, we have.
What were the romantic scenes with him like then? Did he go like this? Oh, are you sexy little
He did.
Look at you! Aaron! Weasel tits.
Is it true that you're really into golf?
I like my golf, yeah.
Look at the way you hold the golf bat. Look how sexy you are playing golf. Are you wiping your chuff there on the little... You play golf, Eamon?
I play around with her, I'll tell you that.
No, we should go out.
We should, absolutely.
Does Ruth play?
Thankfully, no. It'll just be the two of us.
Hey, it's Eamon Holmes! Wagwan, Brebden, big up your chest. How's it going?
All right, yeah.
How's Ruth?
she's lovely. She's marvellous. Yeah.
Yeah. Well, she's always lovely. You know, I've got a soft spot. Well, I say soft. recently, you've been bragging about your sex life, haven't you? We've got the headline here. That woman has run me ragged. That was in the Mail Online.
Do you know what? I hope that's true. Because all you hear about is people, like, in relationships, somebody's having an affair. At least you're shagging your own wife.
Yeah!
That's good.
She is a love machine, there's no doubt about
it. Yeah, yeah.
That's why people say, why do you go on all these programmes? I just go out for a rest, that's all I do.
Is it also true that you're a big fan of Babe Station?
No, Babe Station. Babe Station are big fans of mine. I have been to Babe Station.
And where is the studio?
What happens is they start to sort of tweet me and direct message me at around 6 o'clock
in the
morning.
They can only direct message you if you're following them.
Which I am doing, but I didn't know.
Well, Eamon, because you're such a big fan of Babe Station and you like reading the news, got a treat for you. No. We're combining both of them. What do you think this is going to be called?
Babe Eamon.
No, Eamon Station.
Oh! As the general election approaches, the public are interested in who's sliding down polls. One politician said, "We think we can come from behind, but it's going to be hard, very hard."
Sexy bastard!
The Navy has announced cuts in Portsmouth, leaving unwanted seamen everywhere. The tallest skyscraper in the world.
Remember, you've got to shake a
form
before you've got to Tyson to form.
Do what? Oh,
yeah.
And football news now. Manchester United beat Manchester City despite Wayne Rooney being pulled off at half-time. And finally, here's a quick weather report. It's going to start off moist and then get wet. Very, very wet. It's going to get soaking wet.
Hey! That's a point for his team! Well done, Eamon!
Denise, have you ever been on a cruise with loads of celebrities and you've gone through a Bermuda Triangle Vortex type thing and all your celebrity friends have been Benjamin Button and turned into kids, but you were in the toilet which was lined with lead and it didn't happen to you, but everyone else turned into kids?
No.
Run, Victor.
I'm Keith Lennon. Check this. I went on a cruise recently with some of my favourite celebrity mates. There's me with Kanye West, Katy Perry and Harry Styles. When suddenly we went through a Bermuda Triangle Vortex type situation and everyone got turned into kids. I was all right, though, because I was in a lead-lined toilet at the time having a shit. When I came out, I found myself stranded with a load of mini celebrities. Welcome to Honey, I, Benjamin Button, the Celebrities.
Today, I'm here with Arj from Towie. Word, how's it going?
Good.
Good. Funny thing is, with Arj, I think his belt buckle is made out of lead, because sometimes he turns into Big Arj. It's really strange. How does it feel when you're little? You still, like, know the same things?
Not really.
Not really? You just only know about toys and fizzy pop and cake?
Yeah.
Can you will yourself into Big Arj?
I'll try.
Go on, have a go. Yeah, I think it worked. So, what's happened is the mini celebrities have been at the Umbongo and they need to go to the toilet. As you can see, there's an array of toys on the floor which have been left out by Prince. So we've got to get the kids over to the toilet. But the twist is, we've got note on our feet. OK, let's see. I'm going to be with Team Kanye. Word. And Arj, you'll be with Team Prince.
How are you, Prince?
Good. Yeah, I've got some new... songs in the future.
That's wicked news, isn't it? That's wicked news, Prince. Cool. So it's exciting. Who will win, me or Arj? It's you to decide. Your feet are disgusting. Not alike, like duck's feet. So, Holly's team, who do you think wins the challenge?
I don't really understand what the challenge is.
We've got to pick a child up and carry him over the toys onto the other side. We've got to get all the kids over to the other side so they can get to the toilet and release all the umbongo. We've got nothing on our feet, so that's why it's hard. Toys are sharp, aren't they?
Well,
you've got kids, you know what it's like.
Toys. Yeah, so you've got to carry them. Okay. Well, you just said Arj had duck feet, which makes me think he's got big, padded, webbed kind of
padders. He had literally got duck feet. It was just a slur because he couldn't think of anything because he's lost a lot of weight and he looked good.
He looks like he's working out.
He looks good, doesn't he?
He looks like, if you don't mind me saying, looks like he could pick up a child.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
I would say, don't you think Arj?
Yeah.
Because he's ripped.
Yeah, we're going to go Arj.
Yeah. Arj, Fern's team, me or Arj?
I've got a feeling you've had to do this with your mates after a big boozy night out, so you might be quite good at this.
Yeah.
Are you saying I got get pissed with kids?
No, with your mates.
I think you, yeah.
I think you said, yeah.
You.
Me. Yeah, let's go with
Fern's
you.
Fern's team says me, Holly's team says Arj.
Come on, Arj.
Go on, Arj.
Arj, who's on your team?
I've got Harry Styles, Prince, Jennifer Lawrence, Tom Cruise and Jeff Goldblum.
Who's Jeff Goldblum?
Oh,
you mean Jeff Goldblum?
Oh, Jeff, yeah.
From the film The Fly. On my team, I've got Kanye West, Katy Perry, Gordon Ramsay, Eminem, and yes, Fern Cotton. He will go on the claps. Ow!
Yes.
I'm not playing.
Woo! Oi, oi! Oi, oi!
That's a point to hold!
just trust? Go!
A special celebrity juice, specially special because.
What's special about this show? What's
because you're here!
Yeah!
Yeah!
It's
special! Yeah. Eamon!
Keith!
What's it, what are you like at picking your nose?
Can you touch your nose with your tongue?
Can I touch my nose with your tongue?
No.
Jesus.
Can you?
Christ.
Can oh
you
my touch God.
I bet Ruth fucking loves you, don't she? What do you like at picking your nose?
It's a very easy situation for me.
Can you get your fist up there?
Yeah.
What about you, Denise? Can you get your fist up?
With a bit of lubrication, yeah.
You dirty bitch, you are. OK, let's find out how good you are at picking your nose as we play a game called...
Pick Your Nose!
What I'm going to do is show you a collection of noses. You have to point out your nose. You've got 10 seconds to do so. If you get your nose on 10 seconds, you'll get 10 points.
Oh,
the seconds will go down.
Oh, I see.
If you get it within 6 seconds, you'll get 6 points. Yeah, if you get it wrong, though, you lose all the points.
I didn't really.
Oh, what?
Oh, my God! Holly, you're first.
Oh, no, I was hoping
I'm going to show you 4 noses. You've got 10 seconds buzzing when you can recognise your nose. Let's see the noses! 7, you're buzzed in on 7 seconds. If you get it right, you'll get 7 points. If you get it wrong, 7 points will be retracted from the points you've already got.
My nose is B.
Let's have a look. That's correct!
Yes! Yes.
Well, no, my nose!
Okay, a bonus point if you can tell me what nose D is.
Ray Quinn. He's got a little
Ray
nose.
Ray Quinn. Let's have a look. Oh! It's Dan Bowers! Next up, it's Denise Van Outen. You ready? Yeah. Here's your noses. You're buzzed in at 5 seconds. So if you get it right, you'll get 5 points.
OK, we think it's D.
D. Let's have a look. No! That's Zac Efron. You've just lost your points. Let's see where your nose is.
Hey!
Eamon, you're next. Pick your nose. Right. 10 seconds. That's 6 seconds.
I think it's B.
Let's have a look.
That's 6 points
retracted from the points you've already got. Let's see what your nose is.
C.
I'll tell you what. Let's have a look. Yes.
Oh, man.
Holly thought it was C. Let's have a look at C. Judy Finnegan! Next up is Gino Sheffield DiCampo.
Yeah,
if you get straight away, 10 points. 10? You're right, you've got
D.
10.
100%.
D.
D.
Let's have a look.
Bruno! Bruno! Bruno!
Just throw it over to Holly if you can ID Gino's nose.
B.
B. Let's have a look. 10 points,
yeah.
Holly's
game! Damn it.
Rich, you're up next. Pick your nose. Rich, you're playing for 7 points.
I think, Keith, my nose was A.
A. Let's have a look.
Please be your nose.
You're clever, but you don't know your nose. It was Jaws from James Bond.
No, but they're your teeth.
Another famous giant!
Oh, my God, how weird is that?
Wow.
No, I tell you what, let's throw it over to Fern's team. Come on.
The end of an elephant.
C.
Let's have a look. Yeah. That's correct!
Yeah.
You've got some points!
Yeah! Yeah.
Do you know who nose B is?
No, that's my wife's nose.
Who else do you know that's
tall? You think it's Ruth's nose?
Ruth's nose.
Let's have a look.
That's not even funny.
You know.
Can we cut that out for him and he's a good pal of mine? No, that's going to be the trail for the show, apparently. Up next, it's Fern Cotton. It's difficult, this one.
I think
you know your nose, but how nosy do you know your nose and you've got your toes and your nose?
Fuck nose.
Because nose, not your toes. Hey, fuck nose.
More fun! Here we go!
Easy! Easy is an evil one, right?
The what? One that he looked like more...
Yes.
Hey. Hey. Might be wrong.
Definitely.
That's correct! And the scores at the end of that round are 15!
Gino, I'm going to give you the opportunity to have your own round. So this now is all over to you. This is your part of the show.
I want everybody to know that I've created a new show just to, you know, kind of jizz up.
No, not a new show, a round. Jizz up. Start again. No jizzing up.
No. I know, like, people think you joke about Gino, but literally you can't understand a word he's saying at any point. It's so weird. It's kind of nice to have him in the corner. It's like having wind chimes or something. Just, it's just makes a nice, nice noise in the breeze, doesn't it?
So this game is to jazz up things, and I'm using very cool camera moves. And the case... No, because I've been working all week. Now, I don't want to blow my own crumpets, but...
Blow your own trumpet.
Potato, potato.
So this is Gino's bit.
No, wait. We do this properly. We do this properly.
This is Gino's kitchen game.
Gino's kitchen game!
Hello, I'm Gino Da Campo, and welcome to my wonderful game called Shaky Shaky Flaky Flaky. Now, here I have Denise Van Outen and Holly Woolly Boots the BB. Holly! Holly boobies and babies.
Now, the game is very simple. I put my box on your belt, okay? So what you have to do is to have to shake. You know, you have to trust as many... Trust. And put as many cornflakes out to the box. Hands behind your back, on your bum. That's
and
it.
And you tip forward.
No, beyond your back. And then you lean and you just trust.
Trusting.
You just trust.
No, I just thought for Dragon's Den, if you've got a night out and you don't make it home, you've got your breakfast in the morning.
Where do you get the milk from?
Fern's tits.
That's brilliant.
Hey, Holly, you can have a cappuccino out there.
Anyway, you stand by and listen for the klaxon who said, ready, go!
Girls at a disco, you know, when all little kids are dancing like that.
Let's have a look at slow motion. Do you know what slow motion stands for?
Slow motion?
Oh, I got that wrong. let me do this again. Let's have a look at slow-mo. Do you know what slow-mo stands for?
Slow motion.
Cue.
That's a good game, look.
Okay, now let's see who's got the less complex in the bag. Yes, I do because I'm the host.
Oh no!
It's very, very clear. The winner is Denise Van Outen!
Well done, you got 22 points.
Amazing!
Yeah.
Are you all them? He's like making points up.
We're on the same team.
I make my own points up. So you got 22 points, you got minus 10.
So,
We're going to go to an ad break now.
Yeah. So, I'm going for a tiramisu. I'll see you in two.
Coming up after break. Can I have my lucky comb back, please? Rich, you're so tall, aren't you?
I am tall,
I'm about 6'2".
Yeah.
So, how tall are you?
6'7".
Well, stick that on your head, one of these Progo things. Right. And then I want to just see the world through Richard Osman's eyes. So you stand up now. Wow. Can you hear me? How does Holly look from up there? How's the roots? The roots look well. The roots look shit. Could you do that ad on telly, don't you? Your roots should be good with Davina.
That's my line.
Rich, you know, like about, I say 3 months ago when I lent you me lucky comb. Can I have me lucky comb back, please? I lent him a comb back 2 months ago and he kept it. A comb? By your own? What about my High School Musical DVD? When Richie stood up, he can't speak.
He can't talk, can he?
No one to play for in this final round. It's the buzzer round. Buzz in if you know the answer. If you don't know the answer, be a chancer. Holly, what's your buzzer this week?
Oh, my God, this is pointless.
That's Richard there. Rich. That's Ricardo.
The Leinster.
Ferns team, what's your buzzer this week?
Buzzer!
You're doing the buzzer noises now, are you?
Yeah, yeah. I thought, why not?
That's quite cute, isn't it? Buzzer!
OK, first question. What did Britney Spears seem to do when an audience member appeared to call her a fat bitch this week at a gig?
Oh, my God, this is pointless.
Holly Seam?
Did she eat them?
No, she said, fucking asshole.
Oh, I like it. That's pretty.
What did Zayn Malik shave this week?
Buzzer!
Third thing.
His head. Sorry.
That's correct.
His head.
Why is Rachel Riley from Countdown looking distressed here in this picture?
Ooh.
Buzzer!
Third thing.
She's got 2 on the top and 3 on the bottom.
Is it because when the letters came out, it spelt something, a rude word?
Down.
Wow.
What?
Countdown.
He's saying countdown, everyone. Countdown.
Yes, Holly, you're right. She just got an erection.
Oh, that was it.
That was it.
Oh, that's great.
What has Rita Ora recently had removed from her body?
This is pointless.
Holly Seam.
Gino De Campo.
Yes, about.
It's incorrect, though.
Buzzer.
A third nipple. She didn't need.
Oh.
I don't know, I just imagine that she...
Oh, my God, this is pointless.
A tooth of some sort, wisdom tooth.
That's correct!
Oh,
wow.
That should have gone tooth.
What strange thing did Kanye West say happened to him when he visited the dentist?
Buzzer!
Did he bump into Rita Ora?
No, that's incorrect.
Oh, my God, this is pointless.
He stopped talking crap.
He reportedly had laughing gas on the trip and it changed his attitude on everything.
Oh!
What did Grimmy lose this week?
Buzzer!
Burns team.
Grimmy lost his voice.
He lost his voice after a 48-hour bender, allegedly.
I was on the bender.
Were you?
Yeah.
Well, hold on, lady with a baby. What are you doing on a bender?
Observing the bender.
Were you?
I'm not talking about Grimmy, I'm talking about...
Oh,
the end of the buzz round. That's the end of this week's Celebrity Juice. I can tell you that the winning team is...
No, because I gave 20.
It is... Fern's team! Gino, how happy are you that you've actually won Celebrity Juice for the first time this series?
Well, very happy because we won.
Yeah, you're on a winning team for the
first
time. Now, I did say at the beginning of the show there's going to be a special twist, and the special twist is inside this envelope. I'm going to give it to Rich to read out.
All right. Oh. Thank you, Lemo. Why? Hi, I'm Richard Osman from Pointless. Also Two Tribes, which is BBC Two. In honour of me being a guest on Celebrity Juice, the aim of tonight's show was to get as few points as possible. So whoever has the lowest score is the winner.
That means it's Holly's team!
Well done.
I was Keith Lemon, but I'll see you for a week. I'll see you for a win the last dance!